In this video, we will learn about selection sort. Selection sort is a simple in-place comparison-based sorting algorithm with the time complexity in best, average and worst case as big O of n square and a space complexity of big O of 1. So now let's see how selection sort works. Firstly, we divide the array of elements that we need to sort in two subarrays, that is sorted and unsorted subarrays, where initially we consider the whole array to be unsorted and element by element we sort the array, thus increasing the size of the sorted subarray and eventually decreasing the size of the unsorted subarray. And for that we select the leftmost element in the unsorted subarray and we swap it with the smallest element in the unsorted subarray. So let's take an example to understand it. Suppose this is the array given to us with 5 elements. And initially we consider the whole array to be unsorted. Next we select the leftmost element in the unsorted subarray using the variable I. Now in the next step we have to find the smallest element in the unsorted subarray and swap it with the leftmost element. Therefore to find the smallest element we will take a variable small which will store the index of the smallest element and we will equate it to I. So initially both the variables I and small have the index 0. And we will use another variable j to loop through the rest of the array in order to find the smallest element. So at every step we will compare the value at small and the value at j, and if the value at j is smaller than the value at small, then we will store the index of that element in small. So by comparison 2 is smaller than 3, therefore by equating small to j we will store the index 1 in small. And we will increment j to move on to the next element. And again we will compare the value at j and the value at small. The value at j is 5, which is greater than 2. Therefore there would be no change in our variable small. And we will move on to the next element. Again comparing the values, 1 is smaller than 2. So again we will equate small to j. And small now has the index 3. Now again incrementing j we reach the last element. And comparing the values, 4 is greater than 1, thus there would be no change in the value of small. Now as we have reached the end of the array, so in the last step we will swap the values at I and small, and therefore 1 will become a part of the sorted subarray. Now again we will repeat the procedure and increment I by 1 to select the leftmost element in the unsorted subarray, and we will again use the variable small to store the index of the smallest element. Now again looping through the unsorted array one by one using the variable j, and we compare the value at small and the value at j, and as 2 is smaller than 5 there would be no change in the value of small. Moving forward to the next element, now again 2 is smaller than 3 so we will not make any change in our variable small. Now finally moving on to the last element we see that 4 is also greater than 2. Therefore, at the end, our variable small will contain the index 1. And as variable I and variable small are pointing to the same element, this means that 2 is already at its sorted position. So in the next step, 1 and 2 become the part of the sorted subarray. So now incrementing I by 1 to select the leftmost element in the unsorted subarray and equating small to I, both I and small will have the index 2. And using the variable j to find the smallest element, we compare the values at small and j. And as 3 is smaller than 5, we equate small to j and therefore small now has the index 3. And moving on to the next element, as 4 is greater than 3, there would be no change in the variable small. And now in the final step, we will swap the values at I and the variable small, which would result in an array with 1, 2, 3 in the sorted subarray. Therefore, again incrementing I by 1 and equating small to I, both I and small will have the index 3. And using the variable j, we compare the values at j and small. And as 4 is smaller than 5, we equate small to j, therefore small now has the index 4. And as there are no more elements in the array, we'll perform the swap operation, which would result in a fully sorted array. Therefore, if we observe throughout the process, we were using two loops using I and j, where I is the outer loop which runs from 0 to n-2, where n is the size of the array, and j is the inner loop which runs from I plus 1 to n minus 1. So now let's implement this using C++. We start our selection sort function, which takes as arguments an array A and an integer n, which is the size of the array or the number of elements in the array, where small indicates the smallest element index, I points to the leftmost element in the unsorted array, and we use j to loop through the unsorted array in order to find the smallest element. And then we start our outer loop, which runs from 0 to n minus 2, as n minus 1 is the last element, and when we are comparing the last and the second last element, it would always result in a sorted array. So firstly we equate small to I, and then we start our inner loop using the variable j, which runs from the index I plus 1 to n minus 1, which is still the last element. And at every step we compare the value at j and the value at small, and if the value at j is less than the value at small, then we store the index j in small. And at the end of this loop, we will have the index of the smallest element in the variable small. And when the loop ends, we will perform our swap operation using the temporary variable. We will store the value at index I in temp, and store the value at small at index I. And finally, we will store the value of the temporary variable at small. And we will repeat this process for every element from 0 to n minus 2. So that was all for this video. Thank you for watching.